Hey, what's going on, guys? My name is Pedrusky, and in this video, I'm going to show you how you can add more nodes to your Pterodactyl panel. Now, if you don't know what Pterodactyl panel is, basically it's a game server manager where you can easily install and modify your game servers. So it's pretty much a must have for anyone who wants to run multiple game servers on a machine. So if you haven't installed it before, I highly suggest you go down and check out the video below where I show you how to install it from scratch. It takes probably about 5 to 10 minutes to get started, and it just makes managing game servers a whole lot easier. So in this video, we're basically going to pick up at the end of where that last video ended, and I'm just going to show you how you can add a new server to the panel. So if you've got multiple nodes or servers, this is how you do it. So, all right, so let's get into it. Okay, so when you first log into your Pterodactyl panel, you're just going to see this blank screen here. So we're actually going to go up to settings in the top right hand corner. Then we go down to locations. So before we set up a node, we have to set up a location first. So for this one, I'm just going to call it SG, which is short for Singapore in my case. So that's where my server is located. Description, you can just leave blank, and basically it just says location was created successfully, and just leave that. Okay, then, so once you've done your location, we just go down to nodes, then we come over to create new. Then this is where you get to name your node, so I'm just going to call it Singapore 1. Location is Singapore. Node visibility, we'll leave it public. And then we can go FQDN. So FQDN is fully qualified domain name. So if you're using a domain name for your server, this is where it goes. However, in my case, I'm just using an IP address. So I'll put my IP address straight in there. And then again, so if you've got a domain name set up, it says here, use SSL connection. So if you, when you first set up your Pterodactyl panel, if you're using SSL, you're going to use SSL connection. Otherwise, you'll use HTTP connection. Now on the behind proxy, it says not behind proxy. Chances are if you're watching this video, you're just going to set it to not behind a proxy. Otherwise, this is if you're using Cloudflare or something. So okay, so now we go and we set the total memory for the server. So in our case, this is a 2 GB server, so I'm just going to set it to 2000. Memory over allocation, set that to 0%. Disk over allocation, 0%. And then the total disk space, I'm just going to set it to my hard drive space. And then daemon port and SFT port, we can just leave that as default. Now, when it comes to disk space and total memory, you can account for overhead of the operating system, but if you're just running it for you and a few friends, just set it to your system memory and whatever hard drive space you got. You're not really going to have any issues. So, well, unless you overload the server, but it's pretty unlikely if it's just like for you and a few people. So now let's just click create node. Now we have to set up an allocation. So allocation is basically, think of it like port forwarding. So we're just going to be allocating ports to that node. So I'm going to put in the IP address for my server again. And then for ports, so you can actually open like one port at a time. So I'm going to open 27015, which is like a default source port. So if I click submit, you can see that it's opened up that one port. But what if I want to open up, let's say 10 ports at once. So 27025. This is going to open up the rest of those ports. So that's like a range of ports. And as you can see, it's opened up a bunch of different ports for us to use. So once you, if you ran out of port allocations, then basically you can't run any other game servers on that node. So once we've got our ports set, then we go over to configuration. This is where we're going to put the actual configuration on the server. Obviously, you don't want to show anyone this sort of stuff, but as this is just a temp server, the token really doesn't matter. So I'm going to click on generate token, and then copy this line, and now we have to log into our server using PuTTY or SSH or whatever you used to access the command line terminal for your server. So in my case, I was using PuTTY. So I'm logged into my server. Well, that's a lie. I'm not actually logged in. I'm going to log into my server and I'll be back in 1 second. Okay, so now I am 100% totally logged into my server this time. I can just paste that command. And so as you can see, it's just input it and automatically brought me back to the prompt here. So then we can just test it out. So we can type sudo wings. So as you can see here, basically it's all blue. There's no red errors. If there's anything red on here, you need to read what it's saying, because it's going to tell you what the issue is. And then if we go over to the Pterodactyl panel, we click on nodes, we can actually see there's a green heart. So that means that it's online. So now if we just press Control C, so that's going to stop that node. Now we want to set it so it'll start up when the system starts. So you can see as we pretty much stop the wings node. So you can see there's a little red heart there now. So now we just type in systemctl start wings. And then we press enter. And as you can see, it's brought wings back online. So that means like if it crashes or whatever, it's just going to keep that process running, and it won't matter if you reboot the server. It's just gonna keep going. So now we've got our server set up. Our node set up. We can start our game servers, and we can basically assign them to the node like normal. So that's it, guys. If you want to learn how to install games on Pterodactyl, check out my other videos. If I don't have your game listed, leave a comment below of what games you want to see like an install guide on. Some of them are pretty straightforward, but others need like a bit of work. So yeah, if you want help with anything, just leave a comment below, or even come join me on Discord. I've got the link in the description, and I'll do my best to help you out. So thanks for watching, guys, and I hope to see you in another video.